What I discussed you in the previous session is basically the concept, the base key concept, which all of you must, you know, recollect in one way, again, because we have taken 1 hour on that. And that 1 hour is very important. The small term, it was, you know, could be finished within 15 minutes, but I have given you 1 hour because I want to put everybody's heart this concept, that this is an entity, this is different, owner is different, okay? So whatever transaction is carried in any institution, any trade, any commerce, this has got nothing to do, okay? The owner is also liability for this. This you note down in the heart, bold word, the owner's amount, the owner's capital, the owner's profit, net earning are also liability for this, till it finally discharges. All the liability of owner make nil. No asset, no liability, no payment, no receipt, okay? So this is the main thing I discussed with you. And second thing I want to discuss with you, that every transaction, everything you understand in one set of mind, that if any amount is paid or payable, is either an asset or an expenditure. Any amount is received, any amount is received is either a income or a liability. Why income or liability? Because all incomes are liability for this. Even some professors might be sitting here, but this concept should be finally, whenever they go, you know, in the business world, they should teach this. This is very important. The most, and you know, the highest drawback of our Indian economy, because this is telecasted everywhere, and I am proud to say, and I don't, you know, hesitate to saying this, that the basic accounting system has not been given due recognition in any of the department. They have gone by their own conventional methods. They have never thought that accounting system should be a top priority for each and every sector, each and every department, at each and every place. They created a legal entity, the government of India created a legal entity before the constitution of the government came in play. In 1949, the Chartered Accountant Act was made. And in 1950, the constitution came in effect. Before that, because at that time they wanted that there must be an accountant, there must be a qualified, experienced, trained person to look after all accounting, financial reporting, auditing and all aspects, so that whatever comes in the constitution can be taken care properly. But unfortunately, the most drawback of this Indian economic system is that the legal person created by the government, by the constitution itself, has not been used for the purpose. I can understand all of your problem, because whenever new systems, new entities, new trend comes in, you will not be able to address every issue. You need one professional in your department. You can carry out all transactions. You can make entries, you can understand, you can make, you know, the evidences, you can prepare trial evidence, etc. But for understanding the transaction, for making the financial reporting, for making the figures in comparative form, for analyze the information, you need a professional person in your sector. So kindly insist wherever you go in your institution that a qualified professional under an act, a chartered accountant, should be employed in each and every organization, so that all of you can powerfully take up this accounting and auditing department. This must. I think none of the institution, at the time of appointment of finance people, the criteria is that it should be chartered accountant. Nowhere, I think. So you should have it, because academic quality is different, professional quality is different. You have it so that you can, you know, you can work in the different manner. Whatever, you know, your generation comes, you know, professionals, etc., you can take. Our all consolidated liability is to take this profession, take this country in different manner. If we are not using the expertise, accounting, not only accounting, only accounting you people are doing, but auditing concept, financial information, financial analysis, data analysis, recovery of the dues, taking action, drafting the agreement, drafting the financial document, etc., etc., you need a financial expert. And that is why it is to be taken care. And now MHRD has taken, very good stand for it, that, throughout the country, the accounting with the IKAI is taken up. So we have come to the conclusion that we must have, the accounting concept in our institution. So that you are aware that where we are standing. So this we have concluded the first part. I came to the terminology used in double entry accounting. Now we'll run fast. Okay. If you are able to have, if you are not able to understand anything and you want a query, you can stop me any moment. Because there are a lot of accounting concepts. I'll take it because other lectures are there. Then they will teach you accounting standard, etc., etc. That will go from your head because till you don't understand the basic concept of accounting. Not able to understand those standards, etc., etc. So let us understand this accounting in a very fruitful and a different manner so that everything comes in your mind. So only four transactions are there. Either there is an income or there is a liability. Either there is an asset or there is a expenditure. A slip of mind, a small slip of mind can convert an asset into an expenditure because in one side, debit side only. While making a posting amount paid to Shyam Lal Agarwal, you say Shyam Lal Agarwal, okay, it is always expenditure. So you put expenditure, you given me advance, amount is not recorded, it has gone to expenditure. A small slip of mind is liability. Somebody is giving you the money, your income, you can say, no, I have to pay back to him. It will become a liability. So a small slip of sense will make a income a liability and asset an expenditure. So you have to understand that the side is one, asset expense side is one, and liability and income is side. I told you why liability is one side, that everything comes. Okay. And there are only two accounts. For all practical purposes, there may be different lot of final account only. One is income and expenditure account or profit and loss account. It may be called by any name, but in one side there will be all incomes. Income means which are not payable after the close of the period to which it is prepared. Expenditure is whatever incurred not recoverable anything out after the period is over. Once you incur the expenditure, it is not recoverable in the future. There is no enduring benefit for next period. You are preparing account 31st March 2014. Any expenditure incurred or income earned, expenditure incurred will not give benefit in 2015. Salary paid for March, finished. April you work, you will ask salary more. Okay? So it will not carry further. But amount which will carry further will become your asset because you want to recover in future year. So suppose salary paid for 2 months advance, 1 month is expenditure, 1 month you will recover next year. So next year it will carry on. So that is the concept. So on that basis of that, you must understand asset, liability and income and expenditure. So that is close. I think everybody is capable to take up his mind at this stage. Okay. Now I go to account, terminology account. Lot of terms will come in your life, your accounting. So I'll explain you what is the terminology. You must understand account means one account. So first you understand account means any account, one account. It may be sub account, it may be more sub account. There may be control account because all accounts, suppose there are four accounts only. One is income, one is liability, one is asset, one is expense. There are four major head. Now under four major head, there can be group head. So one group head is in asset, we can say fixed asset. We can say fixed asset. Fixed asset means the assets which are not consumed during the operation. If you consume, it become current. Suppose I purchase a cotton and make, the cloth. So cloth is sellable. So cotton is consumed. I use labor. Labor is consumed. Okay. So everything, whatever asset I purchase, I purchase any item. Suppose I purchase this, I am selling the furniture. So furniture, I am buying this board and selling it. So what the board has converted to table. So table is not a fixed asset because it itself is, consumed in the operation and it will be sellable item. So fixed asset is asset which provides support for the production, for the operation, for the service. They say institution. This furniture is providing you support. Furniture is not consumed. It is depreciated. So we provide depreciation, it is not consumed. Okay, so fixed asset means asset which give you enduring benefit for the next period. It asset side. Other is current asset. Current asset means the asset which is used in operation. Current asset used in cycle, like your operating cycle, your institution. So in your institution, what is current asset? You have given some advance salary, advance for some supplier, advance for consultancy fees, advance for anything. Cash balance in your bank account balance. Okay, all these are the current assets because they are assets for you, but they are changing from time to time, period to period, and at least in next 12 months, they will be converted to cash or cash will be converted to current asset. So they are current asset, they are moving. Okay, now fixed asset, suppose your building is you have made. So building will not be, building is fixed. Okay, it will not be consumed. So like fixed asset and current asset, there are two things in asset side. And in liability side, there is a capital. Capital means whatever amount I have given, I see I will not take it back. It is liability. Ultimately, it has come to me only for business liability. But I have put the money not as a loan. If I give a loan, I will be paid interest. So one is liability means capital. If it is one person, it is a proprietor. If it is two persons taking together, they are partner. If we incorporate a company under Companies Act, it becomes a company. Okay, so it is capital. Second is amount given to this entity which is recoverable in cash, paid in cash, recovered in cash, that becomes loan. If paid in cash, recovered in kind, that becomes advance. Okay, if paid in cash, recovered in cash, it becomes loan. So one is loan and one is capital. The third is the current liability, like current asset, current liability. Okay, suppose I have given advance to this fellow, it will not a loan, then against the advance it will give me some material, some amount, some services, so it becomes advance because I have given cash but will return the other item, not cash. If given cash, taking cash back, it is a loan. Giving cash and taking some services, some material, then it is advance. Okay, and liability, I have purchased something but I have not paid, it is a liability. Means I have taken material but to pay cash. Pay cash to take a material. Taken material or to pay cash. Both are not cash. So that is a current liability. So one is capital, one is loan, and third is current liability. These are the basic terms which normally comes in your other things you will automatically understand. When you will go through those things, what is current, what is non-current, what under fixed, what are the brackets. Fixed means there can be building, there can be fixture, there can be machinery, there can be typewriter, there can be computer. Because I purchase, not be consumed. I am using it for providing lecture to you. So it is not used. Pen, I am using. It will finish today's night, finish, so pen is consumed. Stationery, consumed. But this will available to download all other things, etc. This is equipment. So equipment, you can say fixed, there can be furniture, there can be fixture, there can be equipment, there can be machinery, there can be computer. Whatever category you want, you can have lot of categories. Out of those categories, you can make subcategory. One type of thing you can put one place. Okay. Other culture, other nature type, you can put other place. Or under law, something is required. You have to group this way, we'll go in that way. So we'll assemble the head in such a manner that either it complies your requirement and also we comply the requirement of the law or of the institution or whatever it is. So that way the account and heads are created. So this I will give brief before going it so that you can understand all the concept very nicely. So account, I told you, it is one account. It may be 100 subhead, it may carry 100 sub account. It may be subhead of a main account, but account means one type of transaction collected at one place. Net balance, you can know if I am dealing with Shyam Lal Agarwal, what I have to pay Shyam Lal Agarwal or what I have to recover to him, or Shyam Lal was my expenditure, how much expenditure incurred on Shyam Lal Agarwal in a particular period. At one place, I must know what is the status of a particular type of transaction carried out in a particular period. Okay? Accounting entry. Now, a basic system which we normally carry and I discussed at the time cash accounting is, we have to make accounting entry. Any transaction have to make an accounting entry. Whatever I make, I given cash to the I made an entry. This entity made an entry. Cash account debit to Shyam Lal Agarwal. This is entry. This is known as accounting entry. If somebody is given furniture to this, furniture account debit to X and company, because X and money has to pay. If paid cash, then to cash. So this is accounting entry. Debit and credit, or credit or debit. But first, normally we do debit always. The system of entry is always first we do debit, then we do credit. So that once we give somebody, then we can say to whom to pay back. That is the concept. That is why we have taken debit first and then credit second. Something has to be there to debit somebody. Then only we can pay to somebody. So the concept is always to debit first. Money came, no entry. To whom to give? To cash box. Then, yes, cash box debit, then I credit Shyam Lal. Because I will recover from this, I will pay it. Till I am not sure from where I will recover, I will not credit anybody. Okay, till it is in the hands, here and there only. Yeah.
What about interest on land?
Land is allotted by the government. Without any cost, land become asset of the institution at rupees 1.
Okay, why just accounting entry.
Why rupees 1? Why rupees 1? Because 1 rupee means we have to make account of the land. Otherwise, it will not be in the books. So, standard will take place. Whenever standard will be taught to you, every entry, even if it is made nil value, you have to account for asset. For expenditure, you may not account. For asset, you account. And land for IIT center, 2,600 bigas, kiti hai, jyada hogi na, lot of money, 5,000 acres, whatever it is given by government of India, free of cost, 1 rupee. Or there are certain expenditures incurred on the land, transfer charges, registration charges, stamp charges, duty charges, whatever it is, 1 rupee, 2 rupee, stamp paper, that will form the cost of the land. Whatever cost incurred to you is the cost of land, and that is represented in fixed asset, because land is not consumed. If you are a real estate developer, you purchase land and sell the land, the land is not your fixed asset, it is selling. So it will be current asset, stock in trade. Land 2000 biga, okay, next year sale 1000 biga, it will remain 1000 biga. So that is land current, okay?
Thank you, sir.
So that is the account. So accounting entry, you must have every transaction is to have accounting entry, first to debit, and then next to credit. Account payable means, suppose you brought furniture, then you have to pay this entity, X and company, because you have not paid cash. Account payable. Payable means the company, the entity has to pay somebody. This is called account payable. So you will say, how much total amount payable in this year? So you'll say Ram Lal, Shyam Lal, Mohan Lal, jobi naam likhi, whatever name, you'll add all these persons, I have to pay amount, and total amount payable comes to this much. That is account payable. So individual account payable you have to prepare, then total account payable will be available to you. Accounting period is for, you know, the period for which the accounts are prepared. Year is not specified. Particularly because there can be a separate period for separate account. Sometimes we prepare account for 3 months, 6 months. Normally we take financial. Period means you must know before preparation of any account what is accounting period. So that what will happen when we go to accrual accounting, then we have to account for all the liabilities and assets till that date. So we must know the accounting period. So accounting period means for the period we are preparing the account, or we have to prepare the account. Suppose initially started capital entry, but I must know this day that I have entered this entry, but my accounting period will end on 31st March. So my account will period on 31st March. Till then, whatever transaction taken place, net balance on 31st March will be reflected in the net statement of this balance sheet account if it is capital, or P&L account if it is other account. So that is the accounting period. Accounting principle. The accounting principles, basically what accounting principles you are following, I will not take detail here. Accounting principle, again there are certain accounting principles, we will take it later on. Accounting principle, whatever account, the principle which guide to prepare the account, the principle which guide to prepare the account. Now we say single accounting principle we are following, double entry accounting, accrual accounting principle are following, or some there are certain accounting principles separately also. But for you people, I will not discuss accounting principle as a technical. You should understand only one thing, whatever principle, there are certain principles which are fundamental accounting principle. Now fundamental accounting principle says ki you have to prepare your account on accrual base of accounting. But you are preparing on cash based accounting. You are not following fundamental accounting. So I will not go by principle. I will go by only one thing, that what are the accounting principles, so that you must know if somebody is accrual accounting. Okay, accrual accounting is a principle. But we are preparing the books on double entry accounting cash system. So accrual accounting principle we are not following. So you must know what is accounting principle available, what you follow, they are different. It is not necessary that all accounting principle, all entities are following. But we must ensure that when we become perfect accountant, perfect account unit, then we must follow all the applicable accounting principles to that entity. So principles may be different to you. For education, there may be, the principle may apply in a different manner, or in a different manner. Though principles are same always, principles are guiding force. But interpretation of those principles may be, in your case, may be different. So I will not go what principle should follow, what not followed. Because if I educate that or discuss that, then you will be misguided. At this juncture, you must in your life understand there are certain accounting principles which should be followed while preparing the account. Okay? And one of two of three of them which we discuss. Others, I don't know. If we discuss other and I don't know, it will confuse everything. Okay? So next, account receivable. I have sold you the goods, but you not paid me the account. So it is account receivable. So I have to take money from you. Receivable. Okay? What receivable means, I have to receive. Payable means I have to pay. Means I have not received cash while selling the goods or giving the services. But it is payable or receivable as the case may be. So it is receivable. Simple term. Accounting standard. Accounting standard, we are the regulator of the accounting. So we prepare the accounting standard applicable. As Mr. Patak was telling, that there should be separate accounting standard for education institution. But you know, accounting standard are prepared based on certain accounting principles. So those accounting standards are applicable, as applicable to you under different scenario. But it is true, and I think we have discussed with ministry also, not HRD, other ministries also, that any accounting standard applicable to a particular type of department should be made separate. So that whenever he, you know, understand and discuss the accounting standard, he will understand only those standards. In one accounting, there are thousands of systems which are not applicable to you. So, we'll see that accounting standard as applicable to education institution will be made available or will be carved out from the accounting standard applicable, so that you can easily understand those standard only. Okay? So, standard means standard prescribed by the government of India. Only one. Who can prescribe accounting standard? Bharat Sarkar, government of India. No state government can prescribe accounting standard. Okay? Whenever Trump account comes, it is government of India. Government of India means ICAI prepare, recommend, approve and submit to government of India. Government say, okay, go ahead. Or they amend something, it is amended. But ultimately, it is approved by the government of India. It is not approved to government of India, then till then, no separate account is approved. The account standard prepared by Institute of Chartered Accountants of India will apply. Okay? Why standard is used? Can somebody tell? What is standard? Now, accounting standard is the simplest thing which is, you know, which I think when you will see the lecture of Mr. Goyal and Banka, you will say, yeah, it is very complicated. So I'll request both of them to teach in a very simple manner. Yeah, please.
So I have one question. You have told about that every transaction has to be entered in the books of accounts. There should be an entry. But my experience is that there are many items which are not entered into the books of accounts also. There are institutes like IITs or institutes of higher learning where they have many patents, copyrights, etc. But they are not reflected in books of accounts. They carry the value. They are the assets. Those are the assets, copyrights and patents. So which accounting standard has been developed for incorporating the values of these patents and copyrights? And what is the best way to depict it in the books of accounts?
Actually, what is happening, again, I told you, anything which is earned, you know, that becomes your earning, but anything which is earned as asset and the enduring benefit available in future, that becomes asset. So far copyright, patent, etc., if, you know, you are not able to quantify in terms of money, you take rupees 1 and specify it. If you have incurred R&D expenditure on that patent, etc., that will become your asset on that value. But if somebody is not accounting for, because he is not following accrual system of accounting. If he is following accrual system of accounting, then he has to account for each and every transaction under the specified heads. If you are creating R&D and you are creating an asset, then you have to create that asset as a fictitious asset, as an intangible asset, but as an asset. There are two types of asset. One is physical asset. One is tangible, one is intangible. There can be intangible asset also. So that is also, that there is also accounting standard. How to value, how to account for, every standard there. But I am telling what is standard. I am discussing standard with you. The standard is the simplest term in a man's life. Simplest term. Because in 33 years of my career, I have not seen anything which I cannot understand standard. The sun rises in the east. Sun rises in the east. Everybody knows. If it starts rising different east or like that, if everybody of us, 133 members, you know, we used to wear pants shirt, okay, used to eat something, used to do something, used to work something. And we say, somebody has to, you know, examine, what is the standard of wearing of a man? Then say, sir, pant and shirt. Shirt may be full or half, but it is pant and shirt. It becomes standard. Now somebody comes wearing a kurta pajama, it will be deviation from the standard. So standard means, a general layman having a basic conceptual, a normal level of knowledge will work in the manner, and the work in the manner will be acceptable to mass of the public, means more than 90%, 95% or general layman, it becomes the standard. Standard. हाँ सब लोग खाना खाने के बाद में पानी पीते हैं लोग खाना खाते हैं लंच लंच का टाइम 1:30 बजे स्टैंडर्ड हो गया लंच का टाइम 4:30 बजे क्या हुआ भाई सब और रात रात को नाइट पारी इज यू नो ऑन मॉर्निंग एंड देन सो इट बिकम डेविएशन तो व्हाट इज स्टैंडर्ड ए जनरल पीपल आर डूइंग इफ यू आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ए ट्रांजेक्शन इन ए मैनर दैट सपोज यू आर अर्निंग 10,000 rupees ए मंथ हाउ मच यू शुड एक्सपेंड More than 10,000 or less than 10,000? If you spend more than 10,000, then standard will apply. Oh, where you are going? More than 10,000. Oh my God, see. So there we have to, why you spend, where you bought the money, when you will recover, what will happen to you. Why so much question? Because you are deviated the standard. So standard means, the things which apply everybody or a common mass of general people. Whenever a person working in underground mine, he has to wear the helmet. it is a division. Okay? Because he has to go under such a situation. Somebody going hilarious, he has to wear some different dress. Because there is a division, the country is not covered by all hilarious. You will not carry all the clothes to go hilarious, you will not carry all the clothes to the downward. So standard is very simple. So whenever accounting standard says, first accounting standard says that you should have accrual basis of accounting. What do you say? Accrual basis. Why accrual basis accounting? Because at the year of end, you must know how much is recovered, how much is payable. If you don't know and you carry the transaction year to year, you will shut down the shop at one point of time. For government is not bothered, because government, you earn, you don't earn. If the education system had to run, it will be run by the government budget. They have to see the budgetary and all things. So standard applies to government of India, not to you. But in any other general mode, standard means you must know at particular date what is your asset, what is your liability, how much you have earned, how much you have lost. The standard says, the basic principle says, you must carry on your activity. Like today you are running institution, tomorrow you will also run. After 3 years you will also run. After 5 years also. Otherwise, you are entering the person for 5-year course and tomorrow you are not certain. How you can enter a student for 5-year course? Means you assume that it will run for the years two together. The standard says that whatever you purchase, if it is not consumed this year, it becomes your asset, because the benefit of it will be accrued to next year also. So suppose I purchase asset of 10 crore and this year I do business of 1 crore only. I put all 10 crore as expenditure. So nobody will give you the loan, fund, etc. You will finish 1 year only. But say 10 crore asset purchase and 1 year I will use only 7% of it, 70 lakh this year. Then I justify, yes. So you must account for the expenditure only to the extent matching the revenue or it is actually consumed. It's a standard. Now what happens on after 2 years, 3 years, you whatever asset is there, you debit all the expenditure. So that it, then you'll say, what happened to you? What? Oh, now machine become obsolete. New machines came. Nobody is buying this equipment. Nobody is doing this transaction. So that becomes deviation. So we'll say you have not followed the standard, and deviation is because of this reason. So we'll justify the transaction that standard in this case is not followed because of this reason. So wherever standard is applied, you have to see three things. Number one, whether standard has been followed, yes, finish. If not followed, reason, why not followed? Quantification, if would have been followed, then what would have been the result? Suppose you are earning 5 lakhs per year today. Now, if you follow the standard, what would have been your income? Either 10 lakh or 2 lakh or 1 lakh, what? The quantum effect of it. And then disclosure. Disclosure means disclose, write in the books of accounts so other can understand what happened to the institution running very nicely. And one fine morning, it has gone down. So they will understand because of these specified courses closed by the government of India, no permission granted, nothing has taken place, all building machinery has become obsolete, there have, it has to be written off. So that is why the expenditure has gone up. So this is the standard and deviation. So standard is a very simple thing. You understand every standard in a very simplicity, a simple manner. Standard both is very simple. Not following, what is the reason? So standard will come from your own heart. I have taken more time with standard because standard, there are only, after this you will learn only standards only. What is 1, what is 2, what is 3, what is the account of this only. So I wherever I go and teach, standard is the very simplest thing, as if I am making a simple accounting entry in the books. Only three things. If the standard you don't follow, you have to find what are the reason. If reason, then if reason is affected, how much amount? And then disclose in the books. Finish. That is the standard. Okay? Accounting unit. So So suppose you, in institution, you can have different accounting unit. Suppose separate budget is given. So separate department has to prepare separate account. Okay, separate trial balance. So all department trial balance, own unit trial will consolidate one place. Account, there can be one unit. So you can prepare for institution unit-wise account also. So that will become your accounting unit. Accounting year, we discuss one accounting year. Accrual, again I discuss accrual. Accrual means recognition of all the transactions in a particular period, particular year, matching with that particular period. Okay, accrual. Like I prepare the accounting for financial year, then till this financial year, how much amount is due, how much account is recoverable, how much amount is payable, whatever transactions I have carried this year, all transactions should be valued, accounted for in such a manner that on a particular date at the end of the year, whether it is paid or not paid, whether accounted or not accounted, it should be accounted for on the value for which either it is payable or it is receivable. In case of asset, it is created at what value? In case of liability, it is created at what value? That is the accrual basis of accounting. Now, in what is different between you and me? Suppose somebody is not giving the fees, some students, or you have not paid, not refunded certain money received to you, or you have incurred the expenditure but not paid salary of certain people, you have not paid bills of certain expenditure. So in cash accounting, you will account for only income and expenditure what is received, but you will not account for the expenditure which already incurred but you didn't pay because bill didn't receive by you, or don't pay because you don't have the money, or don't pay because your accountant has not verified the bill, or you don't pay because the officer says no, I will take time, let him come to me. Okay, aise thodi I will not pay this big amount, let him discuss. Okay, there may be 1,000 reasons. Liability and asset, actually what is happening?
If these are not cleared or these are not paid or received, how these are cleared?
Cleared? So cleared means, suppose, a simple example, you take only one example and then make your mind, you know, complete what. Simple example, suppose you have done 12 month work in the IIT, okay? 12 month of IIT, okay? Now you have to pay, your salary is 1 lakh per year. So total salary payable to for this year is 12 lakh, not 12 lakh.
If IIT does not pay me for 1 month.
You does not pay for 1 month. So what I will say? I will make an entry, salary account debit, because salary has to be 12 lakh for this year. Salary account debit to you.
Yes, sir.
Because it is payable to you.
And
so simple
if
entry.
IIT does not clear for years together, for how many years that should be carried?
No, not so many. It will remain as liability. You have to pay. If you don't pay, that is a legal issue. If you don't pay, that is your legal issue, you don't have money.
Is there any standard for clearance of that also?
Standard is, if any liability not cleared within a period of 3 years, or any current not made within a period of 3 years or 1 year, then auditor or the management examine that issue, whether it is really payable or not. Whether it was really payable or not, whether there is a claim against you, whether you have not performed well, whether we have to make deduction, or whether it was not payable, wrongly accounted for.
No, wrongly, it was not wrongly accounted for.
No, but there can be situation, na? There can be situation when suppose you didn't come 1 month or you came all half an hour and there is a complaint against you. So, it was not payable as per law because there is a complaint and you didn't join full time.
No, suppose somebody is coming for whole of the year, he is not paid. No, don't, there is not example, I am not saying that.
I got your question. Your question is, suppose it is accounted but not paid. Not paid, we don't have rule, because that is the entity business rule, that is the business has to do, because the institute or accounting does not run the business. You don't pay, he will file suit against you, will go to the court, then court will tell you to pay with interest. Now court has ordered that you have to pay within 1 month, otherwise you have to pay interest. Accountant will say, if you are not paid, you again credit interest. So we will make entry, interest credit to you also, that we will do. But we cannot compel. The standard cannot comply, you should pay in 2 months. If you not paid in 1 year, you have to disclose non-current liability. It is not a current, it is non-current. So that people should know this much liability has not been paid within 12 months. That standards are coming. But we cannot say you not paid, or if it is not payable, you reverse it. Or auditor will qualify in report this amount due from long period and not paid.
My question is that after how much time that should be reverted back?
So much time not paid, that management and you have to decide. Law says income tax department will, what income tax will do, whatever you amount not paid after 3 years, he will treat as your income. Because liability income one side, na? So it will treat income. He will put tax on you. And accounting people, auditing will report in the books, they are not paying. But if either the receivable or the payable person has to, put claim or file a suit against you in the legal court. Okay? Accrual basis of accounting, you have discussed. Accrued and due. Accrued and due means on 31st March, you have done some work. And the amount was also payable in 31st March. It becomes accrued and due. Suppose your salary or I have given you services for accounting. I have prepared account of 31st March, but my amount was also payable at the end of the month. But at the end of the month, it means account accrued and due. Interest in the bank, you borrow the money. So interest is payable on 31st March. So accrued and due, you are not paid, but interest is due. So it is accrued and due. Accrued but not due. Suppose interest up to 31st March is payable in April by 15th. So it is accrued but not due. So the people should know that certain amount which was accrued and due, payable, you are not paid. But other thing means accrued but not due. It was not payable, I have not paid, I have not committed a mistake. So accrued and due and accrued not due, these concepts has come.
Excuse me.
Yeah.
Sir, all transactions, they are qualified by the documents, supporting documents. Now the, in case of procurement of assets, suppose a purchase order is issued. So purchase order is nothing but it is document. So a commitment is made, along with the purchase order, a commitment is made. Now suppose the purchase order is issued, but the payment is not made by 31st of March, neither the goods are received. Now, how do we exhibit this under the balance?
This account is means basically what happened, what is the transaction? You and your very good question. What is the transaction? You had committed a liability. What transaction? You have committed a liability, will purchase the asset and will pay it. But since asset has not come, you cannot account for. You cannot account for. But you in the books, you have to show in the notes along with the account that this much amount is committed by me as liability. Means ultimately I have given the purchase order, and in future, if somebody read my books, he must understand that already he has given order for 10 lakh rupees to purchase. He is having bank on 5 lakh rupees, so I will not make him transaction much. So he will show in the books as committed liability. So commitments made as on 31st March, not materialized, and also no transaction has been taken place, no asset has come, or no revenue has earned, or no transaction taken place, then it will be a committed liability and will be shown in the books of account as contingent liability. Under contingent committed liability.
Just now we were discussing accounting standards, and there I noticed that a significant aspect which needs to be covered here, maybe you have already planned it or not, that is the disclosure. Disclosure is gaining significance from as accounting standards are coming in practice. Conventionally, we were not disclosing, I mean, the normal disclosures that we have now, accounting policy or through notes on accounts, even that is a new phenomena that has been added to the accounts. Now, in view of the accounting standards, we are required to disclose a number of aspects. There are several disclosures that are to be made. But there is no standard, there is no standard language, and the people who are dealing with accounts usually do not have have an idea of the extent to which disclosure is to be made, or what language to be used, or how go about disclosing.
There are general accounting principles. Whenever you prepare account, there are general accounting principles, and general accounting principle cover all these things. Whenever you have a general accounting principle applicable, it's applicable to all. This is simple accounting principle. If you have committed a liability, you should show in the notes or account. Every accounting will say you. If you have entered into a transaction means you started a dialogue and that has created a liability on you. Suppose tomorrow you given a purchase order and you don't purchase, then say if not purchase, then you have to pay 1 lakh at damages. So liability has come on you. So that is a general accounting principle, and all standards, if not, you know, specified for a particular thing, it applicable to you also to the extent applicable. So whatever standard made applicable, that system I am discussing is that for a specific institution, whatever standard applicable should be carved out in a manner that they can read at one place all the standard. That system is coming. So that system when comes, then you will be facilitating at one place everything. Otherwise, general account is not applicable. Whatever accounts were taken in the book, they are all are applicable. When accrual accounting, now certain transactions you are not carrying, like stock in trade. So institution will not have stock in trade, because they are not trading unit, purchasing and selling. But you may have books to purchase and sell sometime. So that will covered in the trading unit also. Some are applicable to manufacturing. You are not manufacturing. So those part will not made applicable to you. So it is like that only. So you have to understand only the basic principle, basic system, that whatever applicable to institution as a matter of general practice, layman thinking, you will see, yes, it should be applicable. It is so like a Supreme Court case judgment.
Probably my query is slightly different. What I was trying to make out of was that in case of deviation from standards, if we are required to quantify and disclose, that disclosure is sometimes it is to be in the form of footnote, sometimes to be in the, say, accounting policy, sometimes it's in the notes on accounts.
Notes on account.
So
that is notes on account. Whenever there are now the new format which has come from Companies Act, we are making applicable to everybody. So there has to be a annexure to the balance sheet attached. You understand annexure only, but not in a different language. It's a part of financial statement. Notes on accounts. So notes on account will be compulsorily there. Whatever not available in the, because in balance sheet you cannot write lot of things. Nah? So you can refer note number this, you can put. It is already standard practice to prepare notes on account. It is standard practice also.
And what about accounting policy? I mean, just I was. As
you are
I
not
said,
preparing in Jamia.
I'm preparing accounting policy. I mean,
accounting policy, notes, everything is applicable.
Everything is there, but just as you just mentioned, that in case there is any deviation from accounting standards, the extent.
You are not reporting.
Yes.
That you should report.
That disclosure.
Because you are not reporting, because you are not following accrual basis of accounting. You are not following accrual basis of accounting in Jamia University. You are following cash system of accounting.
No.
You are following accrual basis of accounting.
Yes. We are strictly following accrual system of accounting.
Accrual
system of accounting, accrual, our accounts are made on accrual system, and the balance sheet that we, the format that we have, that is.
No. If there is an accrual basis of accounting, there cannot be a situation where the deviation is not reported. It has to be there. Otherwise, there is no deviation.
I do not understand. But
there can be no deviation.
What I was asking, that just now you mentioned that accounting standards, when there is any deviation, the deviation is to be quantified and to be disclosed. Huh. That area is gaining significance, and often we are faced with a problem that the disclosure part
is not doing.
No. Disclosure, how that deviation is to be disclosed. The language for disclosure or the standard. I was trying to make out that this should be adequately discussed, covered by in your lecture.
Next lecture, I am going to concept-wise, your next all lectures dependent on accounting standard only.
That's right.
Next 2 days will be accounting standard. They will also telling you this standard applicable. If not applied, how to disclose.
Yes.
How to quantify? They will tell you everything, standard-wise. Okay?
As far as Jamia's accounts are concerned, yes, it's available on Jamia's website, and there is adequate disclosure. Schedule 19 and 20 is there.
Yes.
You may, anybody can visit the site and see it.
100%.
Thank you.
Alright. Then accumulated depreciation. Accumulated depreciation because on asset.
Hello, sir. I'm from the Northeastern Hill University. I have had encountered a problem about the unclaimed checks these last 2 years. Unclaimed checks means checks not presented before the bank. So can these checks, can these amounts be credited back? Can they be credited back into our asset? And then can the liability also be provided again? I think it cannot be done because it will be repeating the expenditure of the previous years. Though audit is insisting that these should be credited back. Unclaimed checks.
Unclaimed tax.
Unclaimed checks. Payment made but not claimed.
I understand. That is the problem of every institution. Every institution. Because you prepare the check for every payment, even 25 rupees you pay to convince from this room to that room, to the professor, okay? From if you go to take a lecture, from this room to that room, you pay him the convince. Okay, every lecture, every class, etc. So special lecture, you are paying the local convince. Some amount you are paying to some, you know, vendors, or some small amount paid pending, etc. You prepare the check. And the checks are not taken, number one, by the vendor in one situation. And a certain some checks are taken by them, they are not depositing the account. And in third cases, when they are depositing the account, sometimes they are time barred, sometimes they are, you know, outdated check, etc. In that case, what you should do, whatever checks remain unclaimed, okay? And the due date, means the date by which the validity date of check has expired, okay? Those checks particularly you should arrive at in different manner, that these are the complete checks, you know, unclaimed checks, and that liability should be shown separately in the bank reconciliation statement. What is happening? You are issuing the check, you are crediting the bank. Bank balance is reduced. But on the other side, you should increase the bank balance and take the liability against the unclaimed checks. That will create, that will make your issue easy, because whenever they will go to bank, they will not be encased because the validity of the check is expired. When validity check is expired, then it will come to you again. So you can say stale check. You can say, keep a separate head under liability, stale checks, payable. And bank balance you can increase. That is permissible. Because you cannot credit stale checks, you have to carry till it is not written off finally. Otherwise, you have to assess again, and 3 year period is expired, and after 3 year no claim is there, then you can credit that check in your income side or reverse the expenditure, whatever it is. That is it.
Hello, one question, sir.
Yes, sir.
Actually, generally in educational institution, we are maintaining for accounting purpose, we are maintaining a financial year. But for admission purpose, we are maintaining account year June to July. So, for we are collecting admission fee for the whole year, that is from June to July. And how we will treat this admission fee in two years?
That you will, otherwise I will tell you one simple system. Because in education there is a standard system, accounting is already prescribed, that whenever you account for a particular fee received for a particular session, okay, there are two methods of accounting. One way you can segregate that fees by period and say accrued income, not accrued but not due, or income not accrued, or unearned income, if received, accrued not due, if amount received, then unearned income. Unearned income. Unearned income, number one.
You have already earned.
No, not earned. You have received the income, not earned. You will earn only when you will provide the service. There is a difference between receipt and earning. If you receive the income, but you have not earned, you will earn only when you will give the expenditure against that. Suppose I have given you to, you have given me 10,000 to teach up to 31st December 2015. So 2015 means every month 1,000 or 500 whatever comes. So it is not, it is received, but not earned by me. It will be earned only when I finish the last lecture. So there are different between earned and received. Number one. Number two, you can go by accounting policy. There can be accounting policy that the institution, the admission fees received will be treated as the income in the receipt of the year. So that accounting policy will suffice, because that is a continuing accounting policy. That will not have effect in the further years. You are following a policy year to year, and you exact quantum and exact classification of that may not be giving a justice to the accounting. When you are seeing any income where you are confirmed that a classification of the income from one year to other will not give a justice, you may have the accounting policy that this income will be accountable in the receipt year. All two methods are there. Okay, but you have to disclose the accounting principle. But basic accounting principle says it should be segregated in the manner that income earned and income not earned. That way it is the basic principle. So you, it will go by fees wise. Some examination fees you take, some other fees you take. You fees take in for February, exams held in May. So that can be the criteria. That is the regular system. In that cases only you have to go by the accounting system and accounting policies. That is the only thing.
There are certain fees which we receive for 3 years also. In that situation, what?
In that situation, you have to segregate. That has to be segregated.
That has to be segregated. 100%. Like affiliation fee, which is
Application fee is not 3 years. There cannot be applicable for 3 years.
Affiliation fee.
Affiliation fee, definitely. It's a 3 year affiliation. You have to divide it 3 years.
That's what I'm telling.
Nobody can do it. 4 year, 5 year, it is lapse of 1 month, 2 months, coming year to year, that can be covered by accounting policy. Okay?